Some businesses keep their hardware in their place, but in order to secure physical assets that keep businesses running efficiently, you better house your data at a data center. Now, what is a data center? In the web hosting industry, a data center stores all the files and assets that websites and web applications need to function properly. It's basically a warehouse that houses tens of thousands of servers. Servers are specialized computers that keep a company's valuable data. These servers are super powerful, so to save space, they are made thinner and are stacked in racks. And because they're so freaking powerful, they use a lot of power and cooling to make sure they don't overheat and set the whole place on fire. Large-scale data centers often have extensive support infrastructure with physical and virtual security measures, cooling systems, backup power supplies, and disaster risk mitigation strategies against fire and water damage. Typically, data centers are located in areas considered to be low risk for natural disasters like fires, flooding, or severe weather that might impact its ability to function. Data centers are also equipped with their own uninterruptible power supplies, usually in the form of large batteries in a powerful generator, so even if there is an electricity failure, servers and the organizations they support can keep on running. The most up-to-date data centers utilize cutting-edge hardware and software to build fast and reliable networks. Your website will have a faster response time if it is hosted on hosting providers with lots of data centers located across the globe. Even though networks like Google's cloud platform run from globally distributed data centers, their physical locations can affect your website's performance. For example, if your website's audience is primarily concentrated in one geographic region, it's best to choose a web hosting provider that uses a nearby data center. The shorter the physical distance between the web server and the website, the faster your website will be. And to ensure that 10 web users have super fast websites, we have got 12 data centers across the world. Yep, you heard me correctly, that's 12. And now let's talk a bit about the security and privacy of data centers. Data centers use a variety of technologies and strategies to keep both the physical location and the user data safe from intrusions. Hardware firewalls and software solutions like packing filtering, proxy, hybrid, and stateful firewalls monitor and control traffic between secure areas and non-secure areas of the network and protect specific protocols like HTTP and FTP. In addition to other virtual security measures like encryption and two-factor authentication, intrusion detection sensors collect and analyze traffic and usage information to detect malicious attempts. Cisco Layer 2 switches protect against the most common attacks like DOS and DDoS attempts. The General Data Protection Regulations, GDPR, passed by the European Union in 2018, protects the data of its citizens by regulating how it is processed, stored, and shared. Similar privacy laws were passed in other countries as well, and as a result, many companies must only store their user data in data centers located in specific jurisdictions which meet the law's requirements. Data centers have adapted to the law and work with the customers to maintain transparency in the responsible handling of user data. A data center must also stick to the local laws in the country where it operates. Let me also mention that violating GDPR can result in crazy fines of up to 20 million euros or even 4% of companies' global turnover. And that's a wrap for this 101 on data centers for today. If you have any questions, go ahead and leave a comment down below and we'll address it ASAP. If you found this video helpful, consider subscribing as more content like this is coming. Until then, take care and I'll see you next time.